Did you know you have Roundup in your urine? If you don't think so, or you said no, you had best watch this video. If you're getting value out of my videos, remember, like and subscribe. Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani, and this is going to disturb you, unfortunately. This should disturb you because glyphosate, which is the active ingredient in Roundup, a cancer-causing herbicide, was found in, are you ready? 80% of urine samples, this was in the United States, and it was kids from age 6 up, 6 through adults. At the end of the video, I'll tell you exactly what you should do to avoid having this in your body, what to eat, and what you should and shouldn't do. So is Roundup harmful? Well, the World Health Organization says it's a probable carcinogen. Understand, the first level is carcinogen. Very hard to get touted as a carcinogen, a known carcinogen. Think things like Agent Orange, that is. Arsenic, that is. Those are, we know that. They kill people outright, okay? So DDT, which was taken off the market, DDT is a probable carcinogen, and that's banned. And we now know Roundup is a probable carcinogen, or a 2A classification. So that's the next level down from known carcinogen, and it's even disputed at that. Many people think it should be listed as a carcinogen. And to add to that, there's 100,000 lawsuits settled to the tune of $10 billion from people that said they got sick from Roundup or glyphosate, which is the active product in Roundup. Yeah, 100,000 people. Those are just the ones that were successful in the lawsuit to the tune of $10 billion in total. What's the number one cancer that we see? It's non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. So many products coming out of these factories like DDT, Agent Orange, glyphosate, arsenic, those are all things we know are carcinogenic, and there's crossover between insecticides and chemical warfare. Now you may be saying, well, maybe it was a small study, a small segment of people. They looked at 2,310 people. Of those, 1,885. So out of about 2,300 people, almost 1,900 had it in their system, which is the 80%. So it is rampant. Children, unfortunately, are at high risk because they're regularly exposed to this weed killer through the food they eat. It's in a lot of cereals. Corn is the number one crop in the United States. Let me just let you know why it's being used, because if you think about it, the farmers like it, and I'm not here to condemn anyone. I'm here to give you the perspective on it's in your body, what can you do, and should it be there, and is it cancer causing? But what it does for the farmers is it kills the weeds but not the plant. So that allows them to put the crops closer together. They don't have to till or leave a big area to till the soil to get rid of the weeds. And get this, I don't know if a lot of people know this. So Monsanto makes the seeds for, let's talk about corn in this case, we'll say, so that they are resistant to the Roundup, meaning they're GMO, genetically modified organism. So this corn is GMO. I think about 80% of our corn or more in this country is genetically modified. And it's modified so that you can spray everything with Roundup as much as you want and it won't kill that plant. And that's why farmers spend days and days just taking the crops and spraying them with Roundup, which starts to make sense why it is in 80% of us. Now, the World Health Organization says it's a probable carcinogen. Now, DDT was banned, and you might say, well, I know it's a carcinogen. Okay, great. And it was studied to be problematic with reproductive issues. As well, it was studied in animals exposed to it to develop liver tumors. Today, DDT is also classified as what? A probable human carcinogen. Okay, so the point of this is probable carcinogen is very high on the list to be possibly cancer causing. You might remember Agent Orange and other chemicals used in warfare. They're all made in the same factories. A lot of these chemicals were repurposed for agriculture. Imagine that. Okay, so how do you avoid the glyphosate? Number one, we know we're getting it in our food sources. So buy organic food whenever possible. Or, like most of us have to do, prioritize, purchase the organic for the most heavily sprayed crops. What are they? Berries, and many of the fruits that you tend to have, you tend to see peels. If there's a peel on the fruit, then they are usually sprayed a little bit more. Leafy greens, potatoes, celery. Can you soak them? I soak them and then I scrub them. It's been shown that 25% of the Roundup can be removed with water alone from a hard surface, so it's worthwhile, but go the extra mile and soak them. If you're eating conventionally grown fruits and vegetables, you can take the skin off if possible. It's not always possible, but for a lot of vegetables it is. I particularly steam mine, so I take the peel, I peel them, and then I soak them for a couple hours, and then I steam all my vegetables for the week. I love to steam them. It's a very easy way to do it. You can eat a lot of root vegetables that way. What's happening with our food system today? Only the rich are able to afford real food, and it's a problem because as the rich get richer, they also get healthier and they are likely going to live longer. So I do understand organic is expensive. Every time I go to the grocery store, even if it's just for myself, it's $200. Now, next is local. Local is going to be better. Look for food grown in the United States, particularly as small countries and other countries can permit the use of pesticides and herbicides that are even more toxic than Roundup. So that's one thing, is buy locally grown, and you can go the next step and get a local farmer. Your food will be fresher, it's gonna last longer, and you get to know who's producing your food, and you get to influence them as well. I'm lucky I have a local produce grocery store and they have meats and all the vegetables. When you bring them home, half the dirt is still on the vegetables. You know, it was just picked out of the ground. Grocery stores often have everything perfect. The color has to be perfect, and it's a lot for display. Just like the fish, if you're eating salmon, and the wild caught just doesn't look as inviting or good as the farm. But as we know, my videos from farm fish, it's not good for you at all. So food doesn't have to look good, it has to taste good. Next is cook at home as often as you can. This allows more control over what goes on your plate and into your body. It saves you a ton of money, especially now. You know me, I'm on the road a lot. I eat out a lot. You just can't control it. It's very difficult to find real food from restaurants. Many of the foods contaminated with glyphosate are oat-based products, like oat cereals, oatmeal, granola, snack bars. They're often marketed to what? Young kids. Kids eat more of these than adults. So alarmingly, studies show that the children are having a higher level of glyphosate or Roundup than adults. Think about this. A lot of people don't understand. They're using it, or their husband, partner, or their lawn care maintenance people who they don't even know are using Roundup. So while it's used in conventional farming, it's in our backyards as weed killer. So consider finding alternative ways to care for your lawn and skip those pesticides. Next, and this is something important that many people do and are doing more and more, is consider having your own backyard garden. Think about turning a portion of your hard to manage lawn that you're putting pesticides on into an organic garden where you can control it. You don't have to spray it. If you have kids in a family, it's kind of a nice hobby too, to watch your food grow. Many people I know, famous people, they travel with their own cook and they bring their own food to the shows. If you like this video, I put a complete playlist up here on supplements and nutrition, things you can do at home, keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.